My name is Mumisa and my surname is Sonwabo. I'm 41 years old. I've got four lovely boys. Three biological ones and one adopted. I'm staying in Khayelitsha. Khayelitsha is one of the biggest townships in Cape Town.
Khayelitsha is a diverse community. There are many health challenges, especially in semi-urban areas like this, and where there are many different types of people, and where there's a high rate of unemployment, where there's some high degree of violence, particularly for women. Women in this type of environment cannot negotiate condom use, and that puts them at risk with infections like HPV and HIV infections. So the infections are there, and they are real, and their prevalences are quite high in this community.
These community health clinics were a brilliant idea. They have diverse services. So we provide a service to any woman who comes here asking for something. But we then invite them to join our research projects, which we explain to them is about preventing cancer of the cervix. That's our main work.
I never know anything about cervical cancer until at the clinic they were just teaching us about that, and they asked us to go to the study, and I was interested to do it.
This particular study started in 2015, and we have been recruiting patients by the word of mouth. So those women also tell their neighbors, tell their daughters, so we get a lot of patients. And over the last 1.5 years, we recruited over 3,000 women.
When I go there, everything was fine. The staff is friendly, welcoming, and everything is easy. They've got a playground for the kids, and they are welcoming the kids. They can also give the kids some juices and stuff. So it's very nice to take your kids there.
When the woman walks in, they go to the waiting room. It's where we give the health education about what is going to happen.
I was scared, but I was willing to test it because I just want to stay safe, because they say it's better to know before.
After we've put the woman on the examination bed, we take the sample from the cervix, then we put it in the thin prep, which we take upstairs to the technician to test for HPV.
We're using the GeneXpect machine, which determines which HPV type the patient has. So what we do when we get the specimens from the nurse, we prepare them and then put them in the GeneXpect machine, which takes an hour to prepare them and get results.
It's an incredibly brilliant technology. You're screening a woman and you're treating her at the same visit.
Previously, we had to do the pap smear. Then afterwards, we wait 6 weeks for the results, which was a bit challenging because the patients don't come back for their results. So we had to do tracing to track them.
The rapid HPV test takes away two of the main obstacles of preventing cervical cancer in low-income countries. One is loss to follow-up. If you take the sample and the woman has to come back, she may never come back. So that has taken it away. And it has also taken away the waiting to get treatment. So the woman will come on that day, she gets the test done, she gets the result, and she gets treated if she needs it. And that is very important.
The patient are very excited to be treated on the same day, because now they know the problem was detected and now it has been treated. It's something that is good for us and also for the patients.
Being in this small clinic has helped me a lot because I can know the doctors, I can know more about HPV, they taught us about everything. I can know how to take care of myself. I can know how to protect myself as well, because they are telling us about everything. I like to visit there.
We've shown that screen and treat works. It prevents, it prevents the condition that will lead to cancer. Now what we need to do is implement it. We need to do it outside of the comfort of this kind of building.
It's a blessing to be a woman. Women have a lot of issues, but somehow we cope with all of them. And as a doctor, I feel very honored to be around helping other women.